seeking the embrace of my Father, seeking the embrace of the one I love and the one who loves me. One who loves me without condition, the one who loves me, the one who loves me without condition. I've come seeking the embrace of my Father, for it's no place else that I find refuge. It's no place else that I find comfort. It's no place else that I find my satisfaction. I was made for love. I was made for love. I was made for loving you. was made for love. I was made for love. I was made for loving you. Oh, I was made for love. I was made for love. I was made for loving you. Was made for love. I was made for love. I was made for loving you. I was made for love. I was made for love. I was made for loving you. Because you first loved me. I love because you first loved me. Thank you. is your love? How great is your love for me? How great is your love for me? How great is your love? How great is your love for me? How great is your love for me? Oh, fill us with your love. Oh, oh, I believe you're for me. You're for me. And I believe you're for me. You're for me. You're not against. You're for me. My soul longs and even faints for the courts of the Lord. And Lord, my heart and my flesh cry out for you. Sun and my shield, you give grace and glory. No good thing will you withhold from those who seek your face. Just as a deer pants for the water brook, so pants my soul for you, oh God. And just as a deer pants for the water brook, so pants my soul for you. Just as a deer pants for the water brook, so pants my soul for you, oh God. And just as a deer pants for the water brook, so pants my soul for you, oh God. I set my heart on a pilgrimage through the valley of weeping. I will go. I set my heart on a pilgrimage until I appear before God in Zion. I set my heart on a pilgrimage through the valley of weeping. I will go. set my heart on a pilgrimage till I appear before God in Zion, just as a deer pants for the water brook, so pants my soul for you, oh God. And just as a deer pants for the water brook, so pants my soul for you, oh God. And just as a deer pants for the water brook, so pants my soul for you, oh God. And just as a deer pants for the water brook, so pants my soul. There's this longing for more, a longing for more, more than what I've seen, more than what I've known. 'Cause I know I was made for more than this, I was made for more than this, I was made for more than this. More than this. As I wait for you, you're producing in me long suffering, long suffering. Suffering to know the aching of the heart that longs for home. To know the aching of my soul, the longing of my soul, 'cause I know there's more, there's more, there's more, and I'm waiting. I know there's more, there's more, there's more, so I'm waiting. There's more, there's more, there's more, and I'm waiting. Oh, I know there's more, there's more, there's more, so I'm waiting. Oh, I know there's more, there's more, there's more, and I'm waiting. Oh, I know there's more, there's more, there's more, so I'm waiting. There's more, there's more, and I'm waiting. Oh, I know there's more, there's more, there's more, so I'm waiting. Oh, I know there's more, there's more, there's more, and I'm waiting. Oh, I know there's more, there's more, there's more, so I'm waiting. There's more, there's more, and I'm waiting. Oh, I know there's more, there's more, there's more, so I'm waiting. 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 So I'm What does it feel like? What does it look like? What does it feel like to know you fully? To see you fully? To know you fully? To see you fully? To know you fully? To see you fully? To know you to be fully seen and fully known. It's what love is, to be fully seen and fully known. forget the price you paid. Though death was mine, you took my place. I won't forget the sacrifice for to this love I owe my life. I won't forget the price you paid. Though death was mine, you took my place. I won't forget the sacrifice, for to this love I owe my life. Jesus, oh, the wonder of your name. Jesus, I'm forever changed. You search my heart and know my ways. You've held me in your hands of grace. Now I have found my peace with God, a refuge in my Savior's love. all I wanna be. I'm a lover of your presence. I'm a lover of your presence. I'm a lover of your presence. It's all I wanna be. I'm a lover of your presence. I'm a lover of your presence. I'm a lover of your presence. It's all I wanna be. I'm a lover of your presence. I'm a lover of your presence. I'm a lover of your presence. It's all I wanna be. Let this be a sacrifice. Let me dedicate my life to worship you. Let this be a sacrifice. Let me dedicate my life to worship you. 'Cause I'm a lover of your presence. I'm a lover of your presence. I'm a lover of your presence. It's all I wanna be. I'm a lover of your presence. I'm a lover of your presence. I'm a lover of your presence. It's all I wanna be. Ooh. was made for love. I was made for loving you. I was made for love. I was made for love. I was made for loving you.
I'll be going into a time of worship in the Word. I invite you to open up your Bibles to Romans chapter 8, verses 28 through 39. Romans chapter 8, 28 to verse 30. And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love Him, who have been called according to His purpose. For those God foreknew, He also predestined to be conformed to the likeness of His Son, that He might be the firstborn among many brothers. And those He predestined, He also called. Those He called, He also justified. Those He justified, He also glorified. God, it says in Your Word that You call us to be conformed to the likeness of Your Son, Jesus Christ. And in this fallen world, it is a spiritual battle to fight against the flesh and the demonic powers. There are times that it is difficult and the burden will weigh us down, but we choose to trust in You. We trust that You are guiding us to become more like Christ. This is the good will of the Father, whose interest is not in our worldly possessions and happiness, but in the sanctification and redemption of Your people.
Calling us to deeper trust, deeper knowledge of who You are. Oh, we know that for those who love You, You are working all things together for good. And yes, there will be trials. Yes, there will be tribulation. Yes, this life will bring much hardship, but these are overshadowed by Your goodness, by Your love, and we will trust that Your grace is enough.
We will
trust that Your grace is enough. That Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. because it doesn't depend on us. 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 Oh, your love doesn't depend on us. Doesn't depend on us. Doesn't depend on us. Oh, doesn't depend on us. Doesn't depend on us. Doesn't depend on us. Doesn't depend on our right doing. Doesn't depend on our performance. Doesn't depend on your love doesn't depend on us. It doesn't depend on us. It's from the beginning of time, you foreknew us. You foreknew us. You loved us from the start. You foreloved us. You loved us from the start. And no, we can't change your mind. We can't change your mind. You chose even before we could think, before we could choose, before we were born. You chose us, you chose to love us. So we can't change your mind. We can't change your faithfulness. We can't change your mind. We can't change your mind. We can't change the fact that you loved us and chose us to know your glory. You chose to justify us by the blood of Christ. By the blood of Christ. You chose to bring us in to perfect fellowship. Perfect fellowship. Perfect fellowship. As Father and Son, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, you made a promise, you made a covenant to love me. You made a covenant of love with me. whether I believe it, whether I receive it, it remains.
Oh,
it remains. For me to sign, not waiting for me to promise, not waiting for me to show up, do good. It's nonsensical love. To believe it.
chapter 8, 31 through 34. What then shall we say in response to this? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also, along with him, graciously give us all things? Who will bring any charge against those whom God has chosen? Who is he that condemns? Christ Jesus, who died, more than that, who was raised to life, is at the right hand of God and is also interceding for us. Father, we silence the voice of the accuser right now in the name of Jesus. By the blood of Christ, we are forgiven. We are made new and are now clothed in righteousness. You are the perfect judge, and you have decreed that all those who believe in your Son have no record of wrong. We pray that all voices that speak against this truth will be highlighted so that we can fight against it with your word. Christ is our mediator who overpowers all condemnation.
Shaking off condemnation and putting on righteousness by the blood of the Lamb, by the blood of the Lamb, I am clothed in righteousness. Clothed in righteousness. Clothed in righteousness. By the Son who gave it up for us, gave his life for us. I have access to all things in Christ, 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 access to all things in Christ. 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 Access to all things. You justify me. Oh, you justify me. You justify me. You justify me. I am righteous in your eyes. So I'm righteous in your eyes. I am righteous. Jesus, my defender, the one who intercedes for me. Seated at the right hand of God, knowing he's a son of God. Agreeing with the Father, agreeing with the Father. Agreeing with the Father about what He says of me. What He says of me. Agreeing with the Father, agreeing with the Father, agreeing with the Father about what He says of me. Agreeing with the Father, agreeing with the Father, agreeing with the Father about what He says of me. Father sees me as He sees you, Jesus. He sees me as He sees you. He sees me as He sees you. Just righteousness of God in Christ. I'm the righteousness of God in Christ. I'm the righteousness of God in Christ. I'm the righteousness of God in Christ. My very life pleases You. I don't have to do anything. You made me righteous, in right standing, right in relationship with You. You see me. Wrong, though the world shouts wrong, You say right over me. Though the world says wrong, though the world shouts wrong, You say right over me. My daughter, You're my son. That's enough for me. You say right in Your heart, in Your spirit. You made me right. I don't have to listen to other voices. You say right, and that's good enough for me. Let every condemnation crumble away right now. Let every word of accusation fall away right now. 'Cause You say says wrong, You say right, and I know it's true. When I look at You, see me and know me, so I can believe when you call me righteous. You call me righteous. Goes down deep to who I really am. When you call me righteous, you say I'm righteous. That's all I need to hear from you. That's all I wanna hear from you.
Romans verses 35 to 39. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake we face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, not anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Lord, there will be times in this lifetime where we face trouble, hardship, persecution, famine, nakedness, danger, and sword. There will be times of trial and testing, but we believe that your love is more powerful than anything we will ever experience. Remind us that we are more than conquerors because there is truly nothing that can come between the shepherd and his sheep. We are not only victorious, but we will forever be victors, not because of what we have or can do, but because of what was already done on the cross.
Christ's victory is over us. what we have to look forward to. It's what we have to live in, to walk by. We have the victory. Yes, we have the victory. We have the victory. We have the victory. We have the victory. So Lord, when I'm walking through the valley, when I'm facing hardship, let me claim my victory. Let me claim my victory. I know nothing can separate me. Nothing can separate me. Not even death itself. Oh, death, where is your sting? Not even death itself. Oh, death, where is your sting? Not even death itself. Oh, death, where is your sting? Not even death itself. Oh, death, where is your sting? I fear nothing. I fear nothing. I fear nothing. Oh, death, where is your sting? Not even death itself. Oh, death, where is your sting? Not even death itself. Oh, death, where is your sting? Not even death itself. Oh, death, where is your sting? I fear nothing. I fear nothing. I fear nothing. I fear nothing. 'Cause even to die is gain, even to die is gain. Thank you. glory that surpasses my knowledge, surpasses understanding, that surpasses any hardship I've known. Your revealing glory, revealing glory, revealing glory in me, revealing glory, revealing glory, revealing glory in me.
Father, we thank you that your word is true and powerful. And we thank you that when we have faith in you, you will always pull us through for the purpose and plans that you have for us to be more like Christ and to be sanctified and redeemed. We thank you, Father, for your love that is strong and powerful and above all things. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Now transition into a time of intercession for Israel. I encourage you to follow my prayers with your own as we go through the topic. Jesus, we thank you for coming down to earth in the form of man as atonement for our sins. You came to make a way where there was no way, to be reconciled to the Father. And all those who believe in your name are forgiven completely. Through Moses, the Israelites were given the law in order to be in right standing with you. But now you have fulfilled the law through the cross. We pray that the people of Israel will be able to see that the ultimate atonement was made, and that they will be put, and that they will put their faith in Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Let's pray. Thank you. God, you are holy, you are just, and a righteous Father. There is no sin in you. You are pure, you are worthy of praise. You are a good Father, and without consecration, it is not possible to dwell in your presence. But through the blood of Christ, we are now able to be called holy and be consecrated. We pray that the Jews will understand this truth, that you have made a way for consecration without offerings. God, you have given to us holiness as a gift through our faith in Jesus. And so we pray that the Jews will no longer boast in their good works, but that they will put their faith in Jesus. Let's pray. Father, you have made us all in your image. We were made to have a relationship with you. And we speak this truth over the people of Israel, that they were made for relationship and have communion with God the Father. We pray for them to experience a new level of intimacy that is not based on works or self-righteousness, but on Jesus Christ. We no longer have to fear death when approaching you. We are now able to enter your throne room and enjoy true intimacy with the King. We also pray that the Jews will be able to see how much you desire them and how you long to be in holy communion with your people. Let's pray. Lord, we confess with our mouths and believe in our hearts that Jesus is our Lord and Savior. Apart from Christ, there is no way to salvation. And apart from Christ, there is no way to the Father. We thank you that our salvation is not based on works, but according to your mercy and calling. Holy Spirit, we ask that you soften the hearts of the Jews and open their eyes to see that Jesus has indeed fulfilled the law of Moses. Jesus is the ultimate atonement for our sins. He consecrates us and puts us in right standing with God so that we are able to commune with him. We pray that you pour out your spirit of revelation so that the Jewish people will be able to see the Old Testament scriptures in a new light that will lead them to Jesus. Let's pray. Father, we thank you that through Christ you have fulfilled every part of the law that was given to the Israelites from the moment you saved them from the Egyptians. We thank you, God, that Jesus has made the way and he is the truth and the way and the life. We believe God, that you have a plan and purpose for the Jewish people. And we pray, God, for you to quicken and lift the veil that is upon their eyes, that they will be able to see that Jesus is Messiah, that he has come and he has given them a life that is abundant. We thank you, Father. We trust in you, God, and we love you, Lord. We pray all these things in Jesus' name.
Oh, I love you. Doesn't make sense with our human understanding, that when we think that we've reached the end, there somehow is always more.
there's more to find, there's more to discover, there's more to understand about your love. God, we ask for deeper revelation in the days and the weeks to come, that we may stand firm in the knowledge of you, that we may stand firm in your love for us, that we won't be shaken. Yeah, we ask all of this in Jesus' name.